Thanks for joining us today. My name is Todd Salkovitz, and today's AccountEdge University session is CRM with AccountEdge, Customer Relations Management. So what's today's agenda going to be? Well, first, we're going to focus on contacts, using the card file information windows, managing contact details, using specifically custom lists and fields and how to configure them, and then a little later on, just turning leads into customers and tracking them in AccountEdge. And then we'll review all the CRM and lead-related reports available within AccountEdge. No matter what type of business you're in, this is probably a typical journey for a lead you may have. So you'll have a lead source where your leads come into your funnel, and then you'll follow up with them, whether that's an email or a phone call, or maybe even a personal visit, or maybe they actually walk into your physical store. Either way, every business has some sort of lead funnel that looks like this. And the key in all this is your follow-up. And once you get your first follow-up after that first interaction, you'll be able to connect with them and establish the status of that lead. The status being, are they warm? Are they cold? Are they qualified? Are they unqualified? Are they closed? Are they open? It's really the type of thing that you can configure yourself. And we're going to show you how to do that within AccountEdge. And again, the key is all about the follow-up. The more touch points you have with your customer, the more likely you are to convert them to an actual customer. So of course, your journey of a lead will look something like this and allow you to track the status of those leads right through the funnel. Their journey from a lead to a customer probably starts when you give them their first quote, and you'll send them out what's in essence a sales transaction in AccountEdge. And then you'll be hopefully lucky enough to close that customer. They'll accept your quote, maybe give you a deposit, letting you then issue them an invoice. Once they become an invoice in AccountEdge, as that sales transaction is recorded in your general ledger, you'll then be able to track their status going from a lead to a customer and be able to manage that conversion process. One of the great features within AccountEdge is the fact that you can print a report and actually see the dates and the timelines it takes to turn a lead into a customer. So you may be using some of these aspects within AccountEdge today, but there's obviously so much more you can do with CRM within AccountEdge. So here's a brief list of those things you can do. First, we're going to talk about many of these things, including how to set up the 5 sets of contact information for each one of your leads. Defining your custom lead source list and the lead status list. Again, these are important to make sure your funnel is representing different things you do and the different touch points you have and how your leads become customers. You'll also be able to manage what the dates are involved, so you'll know when a lead became a lead by tracking the lead since date. Of course, at some point, you're going to have a lot of leads in your system who unfortunately don't ever become customers. So we're going to talk to you about purging leads out of your AccountEdge company file. There's no reason to have hundreds or thousands of lead records if those leads have gone cold or not really optional customers. We'll even talk about reminder logs and show you how to set those up to make sure you know how to follow up and when to follow up and what to follow up with what information and keep on top of your leads. Of course, everything in AccountEdge comes with reports, so we'll talk about the lead source, the lead status, and the lead aging reports. There's also a lead conversion report, which will give you your average days to turn a lead into a customer. And then you can get a report showing you your lead quotes in summary and detail, so you'll know what quotes you have out. And of course, there's also sales reports. Once those leads become customers, you'll be able to manage their process and take a look at the volume of sales transactions in dollars, in items, or in services you may sell to these customers. So like all of our AccountEdge University sessions, feel free to use the GoToWebinar control panel to submit questions, and we're recording this session, which will be posted on our YouTube channel in our AccountEdge University playlist. So why don't we go ahead and jump right into AccountEdge and not spend too much time on too many slides and show you how you can use AccountEdge to help you manage your CRM funnel. So no doubt you're familiar with AccountEdge, and we're going to focus mostly today on the card file command center. So let's show you how to set up some of the things we just talked about. So the first thing is we want to go to our list menu. We're going to be coming back here quite often. And let's take a look at our custom lists and field names. And we're going to open it up for leads and customers. In AccountEdge, in your card file, then in your card list, you'll see a section for leads and customers. They're basically the same record in AccountEdge, except one's identified as a lead until it becomes a customer, or until it never becomes a customer, at which point, as we said, you can purge it. So the first step in getting use out of AccountEdge is to set up your custom list and field names for leads and customers. So let's open that window up, and you'll see a window that gives us the option of setting up the fields where we can define the actual field names. So in this window, we can define whatever we want as far as our three custom lists and then our three custom fields. And we're going to show you how to use those in a few seconds. So why would you want to use these lists? Well, for example, we have our first custom list set up to be the region. This is where in our sample company file, widgets coffee company, our leads are coming from. And that region could be a geographic region. It can even be as small as a neighborhood. But the idea here is that you're going to name these lists and these fields, and then within the lists, you'll be able to set up the individual options within that list. Keep in mind, there's custom lists and field names for all areas of AccountEdge, not only price levels and items, but also vendors, employees, and personal cards. There's also custom lists and fields for jobs. So if you're using jobs to track leads and customers, this is where you'll set up those same lists and fields. And these are all unique. So you can have up to three lists and up to three fields for each piece of information in this list, in this window. So let's go back to our list menu and let's actually set up our custom lists. And we're going to click through and select leads and customers one more time. So the first thing you'll notice in our custom list dropdown is we have three options. These are the three custom lists that AccountEdge allows you to configure. So you'll notice that we have region and size already set up. What that means is that's what I named those three lists. And the third one, obviously, I haven't given it a name. So it says custom list number three. If you've not set these up, yours will say custom list number one, number two, and number three. So because we actually set names up for region and size for list one and list two, we can go ahead and define the members of that list. So within region, as we described, it could be a geographic area where you can put in anything you need here to define where your leads would come from. This isn't the lead status. This is more of a custom list where you can define what parameters and what field names make the most sense for your business. So again, these are our regions. And then we can also define the size. Again, this is a custom list that we set up, and the members of that list are large, medium, micro, et cetera. And again, you have those same custom lists for each of the other aspects of AccountEdge. So within my jobs, I've set up custom lists for business concepts and training and services requested, and then I can define what those choices are within the list. And we'll come back to the list menu one more time. Let's look at job statuses. And here again, we've predefined what these are going to be, and you'll define yours to match whatever your journey is for your leads and your customers. So this would be the status that you would manage as a lead goes through your funnel. This is important because you can use these in reports, so you'll know exactly how to manage who's in which aspect of your specific funnel. So these statuses can be really helpful to know who's where in your funnel. There's one other list I want to point out. Let's go back to lists one more time, and we'll go to sales and purchases information, and let's go to referral sources. Referral sources, much like the other lists in AccountEdge, can be defined based on how you get your leads and where your customers come from. So you may want to know which advertisements or which client sent you a specific lead or customer. So it's good to have a referral source also set up. We highly recommend if you're going to use any of these to start with referral source. This way you'll know where your business is coming from, and that'll be a great place to start building that journey we discussed. So now that we've set up all the information to kind of encapsulate the sum total of our CRM system, let's go into AccountEdge and look at the card file and dig into some of the details. So we're going to go right to the card list. And if you've used AccountEdge even for 2 minutes, you'll be familiar with these windows. The difference here, as I mentioned earlier, is that leads are the same as customers. You just can't sell them anything on an invoice. And we'll come back to that in a few minutes. So let's go ahead and open up Floyd Abbotson, the first lead in our list. And don't forget, you have an action menu where you can do additional things to any of the members of any of the card file lists you have here. So if you want to get directions or view them in Google Maps or even go directly to their website, using the action menu is a really quick way to get there. But again, let's drill into Floyd's record and get more details. Again, if you've touched AccountEdge even for a few minutes or even for 10 years, this will be a very familiar window to you. But the first thing we wanted to point out is where you'll get those five addresses. So each set of addresses has its own unique address and contact details, phone numbers, emails, and everything else. Just keep in mind that the first address is defined as the bill to address when you're doing invoicing. And if you're going to ship, the second address is predefined as the ship to address. This just enables us to actually physically ship something to the customer. Of course, when doing an invoice, you can even choose another address or another card if you do drop shipping. But again, as I select the different addresses, you'll see that I've got different physical addresses, different phone numbers, and emails. You'll also notice next to the email field, in this case, bensimpson@gmail.com, I have a blue envelope. That allows me to actually send an email directly from the card file profile window. And we'll come back to that in a little bit, where we'll show you how to customize those email templates. As we go into card details, this is where you'll start to see all the things we just set up. So in this case, you'll notice that here's our custom lists. The first one defined is region, and if we drill into it, you'll see the members of that list. So in this case, Floyd is in our Northeast region. I can always add a new member to or a new option to that list just by typing it in and doing easy add. You'll also see we have our second list, which is size, and again, the members of that list. And then third, we have our custom list number three that we didn't predefine a list name for, so it's blank. Doesn't mean you can't use it, but of course it would make sense to actually give it a name so it does make sense for you. On the right side, we have our three custom fields that we defined as hobbies, special instructions, and a third list or the third field that we did not define a field label for. At the bottom of the window, you'll see the two additional fields for lead source and lead status. So those are two dropdowns and two lists that we also put members in for. And we can click on those, again, putting in the options we want using new or easy add. And don't forget, you can always change any of these fields, any of these lists, just by selecting a different option. What's important here is that you want to keep these up to date because you're going to use these when you run reports. So to use AccountEdge effectively as a CRM system, you want to make sure you're hyper-focused on the details of the card details window within the card information screen in AccountEdge's contact list. So as we go through the rest of the windows, this is going to be the same, whether it's a customer or a lead, but of course you'll want to put in some of your defaults. So you'll see in my case here, I haven't sold Floyd anything because there's still a lead record. But in this case, there are some defaults that I use. So no matter what I do within AccountEdge, AccountEdge will know that I'm going to sell him services, which printed form I'm going to use, how I'm going to deliver the invoice, and if there's an item price level, just in case I want to manage items and the pricing that he'll get when I sell him things from my inventory. You can also put in a default general ledger account for sales. So if you go to sell them anything, we'll know what to use as your revenue account. Like everything in AccountEdge, there's defaults for everything. So it just makes sense to use as many as you possibly can. This way, when you go to do any transaction, even beyond sales, you've got these defaults already in your back pocket set up, waiting for you to just override them if needed. Of course, our payment details is where you're going to capture their credit card. So in this case, we actually have Floyd's Visa. Now, it may not be important just yet because they're still a lead, but it's always good to capture their credit card. In this example, we're using and we're connected to our AccountEdge merchant account service. So this will actually enable us to store a token. So therefore, we're PCI compliant. Therefore, we can actually charge Floyd's credit card when it comes time to process a sales transaction or take a deposit on an order. The reminders window allows me to set up reminders that actually on the Mac side will actually integrate with the reminders app, which is a really nice Mac OS interface between AccountEdge and the desktop OS. But in this case, I have a reminder set up to call him about training And I have a remind date set for tomorrow. So it'll pop up on my to-do list, again, to automatically remind me to follow through. If I have any jobs associated with this lead, I would see them here. And just, I don't have any history beyond the quotes that I've set up. And these are the transactions I've already processed in AccountEdge. But a quote is just that, it's a quote. There's no general ledger effect because I haven't received any deposit, which would turn a quote into an order. And there's no effect on the inventory or sales commit or sales general ledger accounts because I haven't processed a sale. So to recap, basically you can only process a quote for a lead customer. So if we drill into this transaction, you'll see that quote. Now what I can do at this point, again, using my action button, is create an order. So maybe I'm going to get a deposit. So let's go ahead and track that deposit. So AccountEdge will assume I'm going to get a full deposit. So you'll see as I clicked in the paid today field, it automatically assumed I'm receiving the entire $78. And you'll get a visual cue with the paid stamp at the top of the window. But of course, I can override that. And I can go ahead and actually charge his Visa card. So I'll click on payment details and enter. I can either enter a new card or charge that card right here. So at this point, when I go to record this transaction, I'm going to show you a little trick. So if I use Command R or go to my edit drop-down menu and select recap transaction, I'll actually see the debits and credits I'm about to record. Again, because this is an order and I took a deposit, it's going to affect the general ledger. Therefore, when I go to record this transaction, AccountEdge was going to give me some warnings. In this case, I didn't put any serial numbers for one of the lines on my sale, but also was telling me that I've selected a lead and sales must be associated with customer records. And AccountEdge will automatically let me convert it from a lead into a customer record. Once I do that, you'll notice when we come back to Floyd's card information window that his card type automatically got set to customer. Therefore, going forward, when I open up my card list, you'll notice that he's no longer in the lead list, but we'll find him in the customer list. And here he is. So if we drill back into his record, there's a couple things I want to show you here as well. If we go back to the history tab, this is where you saw the list of quotes we had on file for Floyd. So let's go back and look at that. And you'll see a couple things pop up here. You'll see that he's been a lead since October 1st. Now, again, this is a sample file, so don't worry too much about the dates here being a little out of order. But you'll also notice that he became a customer on 5/19. So naturally, I would want to set this to be the correct day and month. So let's say he became a lead on March 1st. And again, he became a customer automatically because I converted his quote into an order. And because that order included a deposit, it automatically turned him into a customer record. All right, let's go back to the beginning and start with a brand new transaction. So if we go back to our sales command center and select enter sales, and we go right to the invoice, and we drill down into our customers, you'll notice that I can create a transaction for a lead or a customer, and I can view my select from list in either fashion. But in this case, I'm going to say, show me all of my leads and my customers. And here you'll see I've got Floyd here somewhere. Here he is. And I can use that lead. Now, because I've already got quotes in the system, AccountEdge will remind me about those quotes, and I can either select one to use it or create a brand new transaction. So in this case, I'm going to start over again. So let's say we're going to go through and pick up somebody who's actually a lead. So we'll make it a little bit easier and say, just show me leads. And now we're going to select Jill Barber. And we're going to go through the process and just create a quick sale. So here you'll see our default sales account automatically pops up. I'll put in an amount. And when I go to record, you'll automatically see the same error message, or I should say dialog window, because it's not really an error, that's telling me that this is being associated with a lead, therefore AccountEdge needs to convert them into a customer. Again, I can only create quote transactions for leads, and once I take a deposit or make an order and then an invoice, it'll get converted automatically. So I'll say yes here, and automatically Jill also becomes a customer record. And if we go back to our card list and look at customers, you'll see there I have Jill right above or right below Floyd in my list. Also keep in mind, once you create an invoice for a customer, you can't turn them back into a lead. A customer is a customer, and that's how you'll manage them going forward. Now, I mentioned earlier, you may have a situation where you have a lot of lead records in your AccountEdge company file. And we fully recognize not every lead becomes a customer. That's just how it is. So I'm going to show you how to get rid of those records if you don't need them. The first thing you could do is actually go right back to your card list, and you'll see at the bottom here, there's a purge option. And if we click on the leads tab, again, you'll see the same purge option. You can also go up under the file menu and select purge, because we give you the ability to purge all types of details within AccountEdge. And what we're going to look at today is sales quotes and cards. Now you can walk through this process, and the first thing we ask you to do is just make a backup of your company file. Again, once you purge, you've purged. There's no way to undo a purge, so it's a good idea to have a backup. We're going to select next, and now the first thing we're able to do is actually look at all the existing quotes that are in our system. So much like the leads who will never become customers, you may have a myriad of quotes in your system that'll never get turned into sales transactions. So in this process, we give you the ability to not only delete the quotes, but also the cards associated with them. So if I wanted to get rid of a quote for, say, Harris and Harris, I can just say purge the quote, and it'll get rid of it out of my record. I can also click on the purge cards list, and now you'll see a list of any of my customers who have no transactions, because once a contact who's a customer has a transaction, you won't be able to get rid of them. You won't be able to purge them. And I've got one lead record that has no transactions associated with them. So if I wanted to purge Eva's party planning, I can just select on it and select purge cards, but then that would be deleted out of my database entirely. Again, it's a great idea if you're ever going to use the purge commands to go through and make a backup. Again, you can find that under the file menu and just select purge. So again, you're going to find that you can purge a lot of details in AccountEdge, but if those transactions are recent, you're not going to be able to purge transactions, especially if they're in your current fiscal year. Another thing you might do with your leads is you might actually send them emails. So I mentioned you can actually send an email directly from a card information window, but let's show you where those emails come from. So under the list menu, you'll see at the bottom here, we have email templates. So AccountEdge lets you email, whether they be invoices or statements or payment receipts, purchases, receipts, etc. But if we go out to cards, you'll see that I have three email templates specifically for cards. And I've got one that I've already set up called lead follow-up. And if I drill in, you'll see our edit card template window pop up. And this is where I can actually customize a specific email template for any use inside of AccountEdge. Depending on what type of email you're going to create, you'll see at the bottom, you have the option of merging fields from different aspects of AccountEdge. In this case, because we're coming from cards, I have the option of using any of the details from my company information, meaning me as the AccountEdge user, so I can use my company name, my addresses, etc. And I can also grab fields from the card, meaning the customer or the lead that I'm going to email to. So you'll see as I scroll through this list, it's pretty extensive, meaning you have access to use any of these fields in a mail merge for your email templates. So if we go ahead and look at my simple email here, you'll see I have dear first name, which means when I go to send this email, it'll automatically customize this template and fill in the information from the card window right in the first name field. And you'll also see I have my company name, where I also could have just typed in Widgets Coffee Company. Now, another quick tip, if you're familiar with using HTML and you have an HTML editor app, you can actually create these emails using HTML. Just keep in mind that not all mail clients work the same, so you may have results that differ platform to platform, email client to email client. I want to show you one other card email template that we have set up, and this is for our customer portal. The customer portal is an area that's tied into AccountEdge Connect, which is our web collaboration tool service that allows you to create transaction from any web browser using all the lists that I'm showing you in AccountEdge, enabling me to record almost every transaction, but in a web browser that then synchronizes back to AccountEdge. So the web portal invitation is a way for me to tell my customer or ask my customer to actually log in, set up their account, and put in their credit card details. So here you'll see the same deal. It's a basic email template where I'm using my company name at the bottom. And at the top, you'll see the email address for the customer, as well as a link directly to the customer portal. And again, I've grabbed that field from the dropdown. Now, as we go to other areas of AccountEdge, since we're here, if we look at, say, invoice templates for emails, I can do a sales invoice, and let's click on that. And here you'll see a little bit more detail where I'm actually playing with HTML. Again, your results may vary depending on the style you use and the applications you're sending from and the application that your customer will receive in. If we use the sales WebPay invoice template, you'll notice that we also have another dropdown that gives us access to some of the fields within the invoice window itself. So again, depending on which area of the product you're going to use to create email templates, you'll see access to different areas and different fields that you can use depending on the transaction type itself. So in this example, because it's a receipt for a sale, you'll see the information related to the receipt transaction. You'll always have access to the company and card fields, but the fields on the right are dependent upon what type of transaction or what type of template you're going to create. So why don't we go ahead and take a look at some of the reports you can access using leads to use AccountEdge for your CRM system. So let's go ahead and click on reports. And because I was on the card file command center, it takes me directly to my card file reports. And here you'll see the first of the four reports as it relates to leads. The first one is a simple report. In fact, all these are pretty simple. Just telling me what my lead source is. Of course, you can customize these fields, meaning I can fine tune what information I have. So maybe I only want to see the cards that are defined as leads. I can put a date range in if that'll help me. And I can also define any finishing options, like maybe adding it to my reports menu. So it falls in the reports menu like these in gray. I'll go ahead and display it. Don't forget, you can also use formatting to do some other font options within the report itself. And we're going to have an AccountEdge University lesson or session all about customizing all these reports and forms. So let's just go ahead and display this. And again, here you'll see a simple lead source report telling you which lead sources are providing my leads. So again, it's a real simple way to know who's coming from what source. And if I drill in, I can look at the lead source and get any other information I might have. Lead status, again, the same idea. It's just going to give me a list of which leads and which customers came from the statuses that I've already set up. Lead aging, same idea. What's great about this one is it'll actually show me the lead since date and give me the number of days. And it'll also give me the source and the status. So it's pretty much a complete listing of all the information as it relates to the lead, where they came from, and what their current status is. And then finally, we'll look at the lead conversion report. What's cool about this one is it'll actually give me an average days to convert. So while I can see the number of days it took to convert any one of my leads, it's kind of cool to know what the average is across all of my leads to convert these folks into a customer. You'll notice also that Jill's record is negative 121 days, again, because I'm using the sample file, I was just playing with dates, and I just recorded a transaction for them. They were entered as a lead in the future. That's why we have a negative number of days. There's also additional reports you can access under sales. Let's pop those up real quick. Scroll down, you'll see a lead header. So now I can look at specific leads that I have quotes for and see it in summary. Almost all the reports in AccountEdge come in summary and detail fashion. So a summary is just that, basic information, quickly digestible, easy to read, etc. And again, I can always drill into any one of the pieces of information in any report, taking me back to the original accounting transaction. In this case, being a quote for Sabrina. And if I wanted to see more detail, basically the same report, just with more information, I can display it on screen, and you'll see there's a bit more information in this window. And again, same idea, I can drill right back into that detail. that piece of information or that transaction that created the listing in that report. Again, don't forget, you can also customize most of these reports. And in this case, you'll see that there's a ton of advanced filters. This is really where the magic sauce starts to get made within AccountEdge, where I can take almost any of their reports and using the customize button, get access to my advanced filters. So you could take any of our canned reports and customize them, not only selecting what type of leads, whether you want a specific lead or all of your leads, where maybe I want one of my custom lists, so I might want this specific report, but for a specific region or for a specific size. Again, those are my custom lists. And I can also access this for leads and customers or leads or customers. So again, become familiar with these different filtering options because they can really help you fine tune your reports within AccountEdge. Here also, you'll see our lead status dropdowns and lead source. Again, so you can create different versions of this report. And you'll also see a bunch of other fields down here. I can go by transaction ID or a specific amount range for a specific salesperson. There's our referral source again. If we're using categories, we'll want to use that as a filter, of course. And if I want to ship via, I can also filter the reports by the way I ship something to a customer. On the right side over here, you'll see identifiers. Let's talk about them for a second. Identifiers is a feature that's been in AccountEdge for decades, literally decades. And it's a really great way to go in and use them for reporting filters. So now that you've seen where the filters are on one specific report, let's talk about identifiers. So when you first launch AccountEdge, you'll see this window and it'll be basically blank. But in our sample company, we've identified a handful of identifiers. So again, if I want to use these as filters in reports, I can basically set up to 27 different identifiers, one for each letter of the alphabet. So it's a great way for me to really fine tune AccountEdge even further so it mirrors the type of business I'm in, the industry, my geography, etc. It can even be for something simple like who I send Christmas cards or if they're a commercial or residential customer or maybe they're a sports fan and what type of fan they are. Again, you can be super creative with this and use any number of these different identifiers because again, there'll be options for you in filtering reports. One last thing we wanted to talk about. I mentioned AccountEdge Connect, which is our web collaboration tool, which allows you to record all transactions in AccountEdge, but in a web browser. So why don't we go ahead and open that up so you can get an idea of what it looks like. So I'm going to log into my account. And it'll be helpful if I showed you my screen. So here it is. So here's AccountEdge Connect. I'm looking at my contact list. And much like in AccountEdge itself, these are all of my contacts. But I'll click on the leads header. And now you'll see that same list of leads. But you'll also notice that I still have Jill and Floyd in my list. That's because I've not synced AccountEdge. So if we come back into AccountEdge and click on the cloud button in the upper right-hand corner, or click on the sync dropdown, I can say sync AccountEdge Connect. What this will do is send up all the new transactions, all the new list options that I've created, and any edits. So now we'll come back into AccountEdge Connect, and we'll just refresh my screen, and you'll see automatically that Jill and Floyd are no longer in my lead list because AccountEdge synchronized, sending them into my customer list. So here's Jill and Floyd. And if we drill into Jill, we'll be able to see the same information that you saw in AccountEdge. Again, you'll have access to the 5 different addresses. So again, AccountEdge Connect is a super collaboration tool to enable you, your employees, or maybe even your vendor subcontractors to manage leads and customers in their own sales process and funnel without giving them access to your general ledger. So it's a great way to record transactions and keep people out of your general ledger who maybe don't need access, but they might need remote access. So AccountEdge Connect is a great option for that. And again, you'll see all the details that we have in our card file, our custom list and fields, the dates when they became a customer, my selling details that I set up on the desktop. And if I want to invite them to become a member or get access to my customer portal, I can actually send that email directly from AccountEdge Connect. I just click on the button and an email that I can also customize directly within AccountEdge Connect will get sent to them directly. You'll see any jobs associated, any transactions, and here's that invoice that we saw into the future. If they have a payment method, you'll see it here, as well as a history of any emails we may have sent them. So if we drill into a customer record like Acme Sales, you'll see a lot more detail here because this is a customer we use all the time in our demos. So let's wrap up, give you some more information about using CRM with AccountEdge with a list of just helpful hints. So the first thing you'll want to do is take a look at your own funnel. You may not think you have one, but you really do. So what I would recommend is just kind of walk through that experience as if you were a lead, or maybe even look at some of your old customer records and try to recreate how they became a customer. And once you start to map out that process, use the fields and the lists and all the other details that we just showed you in AccountEdge to develop your own funnel. But again, start off by being your own customer. How did they find you? Where did they find you? What things worked and what things didn't work? Maybe you participated in some Google ads or a trade show or a farmer's market. No doubt you'll know which ones were successful and which ones weren't. And again, you can use those fields and reports in AccountEdge to tell you that. Because once you know how your leads found you and how you engage with them and what they bought from you, you'll want to make sure that they're actually recommending you. So that's where you can use the AccountEdge email templates and ask your leads and customers to send your name out to their customers and their prospects and their leads, enlarging your funnel by using your customer's funnel as part of your funnel. And you'll, of course, you'll want to know what steps you've been taking to close those leads and turn them into customers. Is that an easy journey? How many steps does it take? What communications do you send? Is there anything you would do differently? And you'll always want to make sure you've got quality content, whether it's the forms you're sending out of AccountEdge, your invoices, even if it's the checks you're printing and mailing. You'll want to make sure you're customizing those using AccountEdge's tools to deliver quality communications always in all the various ways coming out of your accounting system. Even if you're doing some of these steps outside of AccountEdge, it's important to recognize that anytime your customer sees anything with your logo on it, that's just a representation of your business and your brand. And one thing we like to say in our own office is we always want to punch above our weight. Much like all of you, Activity or Priority Software is also a small business. And we always endeavor to punch above our weight to make sure our graphics look good, our content is professional in everything we do. And again, you have the tools you probably already need right in AccountEdge. You don't need additional services. You don't need additional web tools. You can probably start with AccountEdge and get to a point where you're comfortable managing your own sales funnel and turning your leads into customers. And finally, to close out, we always want to make sure you know how to get help in AccountEdge. Of course, we have a New Jersey-based support team. And if you're a new AccountEdge customer, you'll get 30 days of free telephone support. We have online support as well. And then we have support plans that you can invest in to make sure you're getting the help you need when you need it. Our support plans also include an optional payroll support plan. So if you're running payroll on AccountEdge, you'll want to make sure your payroll tax tables are up to date. We have a knowledge base that also has hundreds and hundreds of articles written by our tech support reps over all these many years for all the many versions of AccountEdge. These are great how-to articles, and they even include details about the latest payroll changes and anything else related to AccountEdge. Our YouTube channel also has hundreds of videos and recorded webinars just like this one. So you want to take a look at our YouTube channel at youtube.com/AccountEdge, where you can get details and watch these videos and, you know, slow them down, take a look and see what we're doing. Our monthly newsletter, which is actually set to go out this afternoon, is also full of some tips and tricks to help you use AccountEdge more effectively. So be sure you're getting that newsletter. And if you're not, drop us a line. Or you can also visit our knowledge base, where we have an archive of all our newsletters going back 5 years. And you can also subscribe if you're not already getting it. In addition, on the front page of our website, at the footer, you can get access to our local experts. These are folks who could come to your office or, especially today, who work remotely to help train you on how to use AccountEdge and can fine-tune everything we've explained today to fit your business. And finally, make sure your accountant has a copy of AccountEdge. No matter which platform you're on, because our company files are cross-platform, if you're a Mac user, we'll give your accountant, who's probably using a PC, or at least most likely using a PC, and they can actually open up your AccountEdge company file. It makes it easier for them to do their job and then just export any transactions that they may want you to record. They can email you those transactions as a text file, and then you can easily import them right back into AccountEdge. Our goal is to make sure you and your accountant and your AccountEdge company file are all on the same page. I want to thank you for spending about 40 minutes with us today. We'll remain on the line so we can make sure we answer any remaining questions. And again, look for a recorded version of this up on our YouTube channel in our AccountEdge University playlist sometime later tonight or early tomorrow morning. And again, we're going to have more sessions every Tuesday, so feel free to join us next Tuesday, the same bat time, same bat location, where we're going to talk about other aspects of AccountEdge, and we'll be doing that through the end of June. Again, thanks for joining us today. Thank you, Lauren, for answering the questions, and we're going to remain on the line until all those questions have been answered. I want to thank everybody again. Have a great day and stay safe out there.